Good evening and welcome to our family virtual session for students transitioning to our middle school. I'm Lisa Miller and I'm here with our administrative team to help answer your questions and share information about our amazing school. We understand that this is a very big decision for families and which school to go to, as you need to meet the needs of your child. Tonight we'll begin with a video of the work was created by our very own students. We're very proud of this video and of the work that went into it. After the video, which is approximately 15 minutes, we'll share with you additional information. In the chat, you're able to ask questions and our admin team will answer them as they come up. If there are general questions that may be benefit to others, we'll answer them near the end of the presentation. We were so impressed with the questions that your children asked of us this week, and it was just a pleasure to be able to present to them. So now we welcome you to join us to watch the video created by our very own students here at Father Mercredi.
We acknowledge that Treaty 8, on which we stand, is the ancestral land of the Indigenous peoples, homeland of the Métis, and its common home to everyone in the virtue of God, our Creator's gracious gift.
Hi, I'm Caden.
And I'm Avery.
We are excited to introduce you to what life is like at Father Mercredi.
First, we would like to introduce our school principal, Ms. Miller, as she will lead us on in a prayer and welcome.
Hello to all our potential Father Mercredi trappers. I'm Lisa Miller. I'm the principal here at Father Mercredi, and it's an honor and privilege to walk these halls each and every day. Our tradition here at Father Mercredi is to start each day in prayer, so I'm hoping you'll join me in that capacity. So let's take the honor and privilege to bow our heads and pray together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Please remember, as we pray, learn, and celebrate, we do so on the Indigenous lands of the people of Treaty 8 and the homeland of the Métis. God of wisdom, we praise you for the wonder of our being, for our minds, bodies, and spirits. Be with our future Grade 7 trappers as they start to think about beginning their school year here at Father Mercredi. Bless them, bless their families, the teachers and the staff at the schools they are currently within. Give these young people the strength and grace as their bodies grow, and grant them wisdom and knowledge. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. So as I said, I'm Lisa Miller. I'm the principal here at Father Mercredi. What a wonderful school we have for you to join. And as well, we hope that when you're here and choose to come our way, that you take advantage of all the opportunities that lie ahead of you. We have a very strong academic program here at Father Mercredi. Also, our athletics are top-notch, a lot of different academies, etc. And we have a lot of CTS courses where you can build your skills. Another program that we have here at Father Mercredi that isn't available in other schools is the Indigenous Entrepreneurship Program, which you can join in your high school. Again, just an exceptional program for all those individuals that are looking at creating their own companies and such. So again, we hope you watch our film, watch it carefully. It's very creative, and you'll find some questions that you have for us. Get those ready, and we'll meet you in our virtual meeting later on. Thank you, and God bless.
Thank you, Ms. Miller. At Father Mercredi, we are a trapper family and are welcoming to everyone who may want to choose our school next year.
Today, we'll be looking at some of the great things here at Father Mercredi, and we'll be answering some of the most asked questions about coming to middle school.
First up, what does the average day look like for a grade 7 student?
When does school start and where do you go when you arrive?
Our doors open at 8 a.m. for students and teachers. We'll be in their classrooms at 8:30. Our first bell is at 8:45 and our announcements start at 8:50. We have a breakfast program for students that come early and do not have a chance to eat.
What kind of classes would you take?
So when you come to Merc, just like in elementary school, you would do all of the core classes, math, language arts, science, social studies, health and religion, and phys ed. One really cool thing about coming to Merc is our academy programs and some of the electives that we have. I think someone's going to tell you more about that later, but I can tell you now that that's a great way to try out a whole different variety of options.
Is there a recess and what time is lunch?
So at Merc, we have a full hour for lunch. That's 30 minutes in the classroom to eat your lunch and 30 minutes outside to play. We're eating in the classrooms right now, and likely we'll be doing that again next year. And then when you go outside, if it's warm enough, you can borrow some sports equipment from the classrooms. You can go out into the field. Both the classroom, lunch break, and outside will be supervised. If you happen to be going out for lunch with your parent, the adult has to call into the school to let us know, and then you will sign out at the office.
How many teachers will you have?
In grade 7 at Father Merc, you will have two core teachers. You'll have a teacher that should teach you math and science and another teacher for English and social studies. You'll get to know your teachers quite regularly and get to know them on a personal level. Your phys ed teacher will be typically the same phys ed teacher all year. You'll have a different elective teacher for various electives, but you'll get to know your core teachers quite well.
If you're nervous about going to a big school, don't be.
Don't be worried or stressed out when coming to Father Mercredi. We have everything here to keep you safe and happy in grade 7. Everything that you'll need is very, very close to your classrooms. We have washrooms, vending machines, water fountains, and all your peers in the back atrium. We have separate entrances for grade 7s, and when you're unsure, there's a safe adult that you can surround yourself or ask questions to near you.
What are some rules in middle school?
While middle school is a big change from elementary school, there are lots of rules that are the same as elementary school. For example, students are to keep their cell phones in their backpack during class time. They are allowed to be on them during lunch times. Students are allowed to wear hats in middle school. We just ask that you take your hat off during religious practices and during our O Canada in the morning. Students are required to stay on campus during the entire day unless you're going to an academy or if we're going on a field trip.
Now we would like to introduce some real important people here.
Our main office is where students can get help on their day-to-day questions here at Father Mercredi.
Here at Merc, we have the best of staff here. If you're looking for any help, if you need a Band-Aid, a snack, or to call home, you can come look at the staff here.
At Father Mercredi, students have many supports to help them to be successful. Some of these include meeting with your vice principal, classroom support teacher, counselor, and Indigenous educator.
Up next, we have Julian to help us explore electives and the great opportunities that students have here depending on their different interests.
The best thing about electives is the ability to explore where your interests may be. You get to switch up your electives in grade 7, so you have a lot of opportunities to try things out. For example, in middle school, I was able to do instrumental band and robotics and engineering. Other electives include art, video production and photography, food studies, and cosmetology. Let's check out this video for a closer look.
Thank you.
Thanks, Julian. I really enjoyed cosmetology, mechanics, and construction as some of my electives. Next up, we're going to be talking about athletic academies.
Athletic academies typically happen during elective time. Registration for academies happen before the end of the school year, as these programs do require a fee to participate in.
At Merck, we have a variety of different sport academies, which include martial arts, swim, hockey, baseball, basketball, cheer, and volleyball. And you can join whether you have experience or are new to the sport.
Academies typically take place during elective times. Students will meet with their coaches and may travel to off-site facilities such as Mack Island or Center Fireplace to work on developmental skills.
Please note that when academy registration opens, it is really important you call the school to make sure you hold your spot for September. You may be asked to pay a refundable deposit to hold your spot in an academy. Academies do fill up fast and you don't want to miss out. Keep up with our social media to stay informed.
Thank you to our Academy students for giving us a look at academies. Father Mercredi provides many opportunities for students outside of school to learn and help others. Here are some examples of things students can get involved in.
Santa's Anonymous is a really great way to get involved and help out the community. Each year, we get together to pack hampers around Christmas time for less fortunate families. I have been involved with Santa's Anonymous for many, many years, and it's a great way to get involved in the Trapper family and meet other Trappers.
I've been part of competitive robotics since I was in grade 7. In robotics, you learn a lot about teamwork and problem solving, and you even get to travel all over Alberta or even across Canada.
Our school is a safe and inclusive space. One club that really promotes this is Safe Zone. Safe Zone is an after-school club for all students who are wanting to make Merck a better place. I really like Safe Zone because it's a place where you can go and just be yourself.
There are a lot of opportunities that occur throughout the year. There are charity challenges, food bank and animal shelter fundraisers, and so much more. At Father Mercredi, there is always something for everyone to do. For an example, through sports, I got to take a trip to California. If you're looking for a large or small role, there is always something fun to do.
I have really enjoyed being able to help out with different community initiatives, such as Santa's. I also really enjoyed being able to play sports here as a Trapper. Up next, we have some more information about athletics.
Father Mercredi offers athletes many opportunities to develop and learn a specific skill in their sport. Starting in grade 7, students can play basketball, volleyball, football, track and field, cross-country running, badminton, and soccer.
Can't wait to be able to show my Trapper Pride and Tiana athletes. Finally, you may have some important questions about middle school. Here are some most asked questions.
We have asked some of our current grade sevens to help us with these following questions.
How do I get to school? If you live on the south side of the bridge, you will catch a yellow bus. Otherwise, you will take public transit, which has special times for our bell times for students.
How many homeroom classes are in grade 7? There's usually 6 to 8 homeroom classes, and it's a great way to meet new friends.
Do we get lockers? Usually grade 7s do get lockers, but this year we did not assign any students to get lockers. We'll keep you posted when we get closer to school, but from now on, you should still practice using a combination lock or a lock with a key.
What about clubs? Yes, we have clubs. This year has looked a little bit different, but don't worry. The school has lots of stuff you can join to keep you busy.
One frequently asked question is, do we use Google Classroom and how do we check our marks? All teachers in grade 7 use Google Classroom and Edsby. Google Classroom allows you to stay up to date with assignments and notes. Edsby in middle school is used to help you track your academic progress and attendance.
Wow, that is a lot of great information. We really hope this answers some of your questions and will help you to make an important decision for grade 7.
If we did not answer all your questions, don't worry. Your grade 6 teacher will sign up to have a virtual meeting with an administrator from Father Mercredi to answer any other questions you may have.
Also, you can reach out to Father Mercredi at any time. The staff here is amazing and will be willing to help you at any time with any unanswered questions.
A big shout out to the production team who put this video together. Thank you for watching.
Once again, thanks for watching. And we certainly are so proud that that was student created. So that's one of the great things about joining us here as a trapper. You get those opportunities to do things such as create videos and share your talents. I'm Kirsten McConnell. I'm one of the vice principals here at Father Mercredi School. So welcome and thanks for being with us this evening. When you come to Father Mercredi, there are a lot of people here who are going to work with your child to make this a great opportunity and an easy transition. We have a large support team, including classroom support teachers, counselors, an Indigenous liaison, and you got to see a few of the people who work in our front office as our office administrators. We have a school librarian. We have lots of people who are going to try their very best to make this as easy as possible. We also have a learning coach who works with our team of teachers with curriculum and guidance in instruction. Very similar to elementary school, students will have the following core subjects. In grade 7, there will be two primary teachers. One will teach English and social studies. The other teacher will teach math and science. Students will have a separate phys ed teacher, and their homeroom teacher will teach them religion and health. This year, because of protocols, as was mentioned, I believe in our video, students stayed in the classroom and teachers came to them and did the changes around. In other years, students had typically traveled between classrooms. Our grade 7 classrooms, though, are located in a dedicated wing here at the school. And we actually also have dedicated vending machines just for grade 7 students. Part of being more independent and organized is usually that they would also have lockers, but as was shared this year, because of protocols, we didn't do that. So we'll launch more information as we know more about those sorts of things next year. Students need indoor shoes, but we don't change our shoes at the school front doors. We also have a dedicated grade 7 door. All items this year were stored in the classroom. Even in other years, students don't get a dedicated space in phys ed to have lockers down in the phys ed area. So they just need to come to school wearing things that will get them through the day.
when we get closer to the beginning of the school year, we will send out a school supply list, but we ask that you don't go buy a lot of things because we always modify that as we go. I'm going to let Ms. Van Lingen, Darren Van Lingen, one of our other vice principals, speak about electives next. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Welcome. It's been really nice to be able to talk to all the grade sixes this week virtually. We do miss having them come to the school so that we can give them a tour and especially show them our different CTS and Science and Technology Center so that they know what kind of electives that they're able to take in their years at Father Merck. But it was really nice being able to virtually meet their classrooms. So for electives, these are courses that lie outside of the core classes, and typically students choose these electives based on their interests. This year, we did it a little bit differently, and the class went to different electives as a class instead of individual students going to different electives on their own. So I will share some information about our electives, and again, next year we will see what the process will be for how our electives roll out. At Father Merck, we're really lucky to have different types of electives, and we're really lucky to have our Science and Technology Center. Our Communication Technology program, which is photography, videography, and animation, those students were actually responsible for making our video that you saw. So those students, we had two in grade 9 and two in grade 12, worked on videoing different things. Some of those students, the two in grade 9, actually are part of our robotics program as well and have been trained to use the drone. So they were using some of the drone footage in order to create that video. We also have things like computer science where students do modeling and programming. This week, we actually had one of our high school students competing provincially in Skills Alberta for web design, where he created a website from scratch with all the programming. Some of our other science and tech courses include pre-engineering and robotics and CAD and CAM, which is using digital design to create objects. As well, we have different electives, including art, foods and nutrition. Foods is very popular because students get to go and they get to make the food and then eat it. We have fashion studies and cosmetology. And then when they get into grade 8 and grade 9, they're more eligible to use the construction and the automotive programs. We typically wait for grade 8 and grade 9 for students to participate in construction and automotives just because of safety and class sizes. As well, every year we have different types of electives that are run by some of the homeroom teachers during the elective schedule. So some of those can include drama, glee, outdoor education, and with our Indigenous educator, we do Indigenous cultural studies. We also have music electives through our music program. So during school time, students are eligible to take Introduction to Band if they want to learn an instrument, as well as they can take concert band once they become more familiar with the theory and practical applications. We also have an intro to guitar. Outside of school for an extracurricular, students are able to join jazz band and the choir. And so jazz band and choir are open for grades from 7 to 12. Up next, Mr. Power is going to talk to our academies.
Okay, welcome. Thank you all for joining us this evening. As Ms. Van Lingen had shared, I am Mr. Power, and I am the current grade 7 vice principal here at Father Mercredi, and I'm really excited for our new trappers. As Ms. Van Lingen had just shared, it's been great. We've been able to meet virtually with all your children, share some of this information, and we've sent some different prizes for each school. So we're hoping that your children have been able to come home with those and share their excitement for coming to middle school, whatever one it is that they choose to go to. I have the opportunity to speak to academies, which is one of our programs that run during school time. And it replaces that of times that students would be going to elective classes. So if your child were to participate in an academy, they may be substituting their elective time for their academy time for a period of the school year. We are very proud that we have a variety of courses that lead into our high school elective pathway. And actually, some of our academies also do that same thing. So some of our academies, you could start out in the middle school and then move into the high school academies as you progress. Our academies are intended to promote skill development, and no matter their entry level, we encourage positive social relationships and to just enhance the knowledge of a given sport for any student. So with academies, they are chosen prior to the beginning of school as they determine the homeroom students are placed into. They are optional for students, as we said, as they do require a registration fee. And students who register in our academies must do so prior to the start of school, just so that we can ensure that they are placed in the appropriate homeroom class that suits their needs. For this year, sport academy registrations are going to begin on May 3rd. We are going to post a form with a registration link as well as a payment link on our Facebook page and in our new information section of our website for parents and students to register for our academies. At that time, deposits are going to be required so that we can ensure that there is space for your child in the academy. Again, that date is on May 3rd, and the registration link is going to be provided on our Facebook page, as well as in the new student information section of our webpage. Fees for each academy do range based upon the length of time of the academy and what it entails at each academy. So this year, our fees range from $700 to $1,400, depending on academy. And as we continue to develop our partnerships throughout the remainder of this school year, those fees will be adjusted, which will be shared with you again on May 3rd. All of our academies, with the exception of martial arts, travel off-site, which means students will take a bus from our school to one of our partnerships within the community to continue to work on their athletic skills. The fees that are associated with each academy are intended to pay for that busing cost, facility rentals, sport-specific coaches, as well as academy apparel that each student is given at the beginning or approximately at the middle of their academy when we know appropriate sizing when we meet our student athletes. The academies that we will be offering in the 2021-2022 school year are hockey, baseball, swim, cheerleading, volleyball, basketball, and martial arts. Our hockey academy students participate in this academy at Center Fireplace, which is just over across the field from Father Mercredi High School. We have a heated sea can at the Center Fireplace, ready for our students to drop their equipment off in the morning and pick up in the afternoon. And again, that sea can is heated, so you don't have concern with students' equipment becoming damaged based upon the temperature. As well, there is a lock that is placed on the sea can, which is only opened by our academy instructors. We do have two academy instructors for our hockey academy that go on to the ice with our students. As well, we do have a partnership with the Fort McMurray Oil Barons to support our athletic academy. Our baseball academy students participate in two different areas. During the summer months, or I guess spring and fall months, students go and participate at the Ross Henniger Field close to Father Mercredi. And during the winter months, students travel down to McDonald Island where they participate in indoor baseball. We continue to have a positive working relationship and collaboration with Fort McMurray Minor Baseball as their instructor supports our academy during the school year. Again, this academy is going to replace electives, so as students plan to come to Father Mercredi, when choosing an academy, they need to know that that is going to be a replacement for certain courses, electives that they may be wanting to take. Our swim academy students participate in this academy out of McDonald Island. It's funny, we had students who watched our video and asked if we had a pool on site. No, we do not have a pool on site, but students do in fact travel down to one of the best recreation centers in Canada, I would say, and they participate in our swim academy. Again, this is open to all levels as students are, when students participate in the swim academy, they go through a variety of different trials using our swim instructors to determine what's best place for them, with the end goal being that McDonald Island would like to to have them certified as lifeguards for future employment. They work on life-saving through their bronze certification, first aid, and Red Cross assistant lifeguarding. This academy also would be replacing electives, and students who participate in the swim academy are required to use the Mac Island facility responsibly and again get themselves to the bus where they would meet their swim teacher to go down and meet their swim instructors at McDonald Island throughout the school day. Our Cheer Academy students participate out of the Premier Academy facility, which is in Gregoire. Students who participate with this academy participate with the instructor from Premier Academy named Kiera Peltz, and she is a level 6 instructor. Those students who participate in our Cheer Academy also get a discount from if they are to also enroll in Premier Academy with Ms. Peltz. Our Volleyball and Basketball Academy students are bused off-site, and they work with various different athletes to support their and enhance their skills at both of these sports. These academies run together in that they would be sharing a bus as well as be going to the same facility during their time of instruction. Our Martial Arts Academy is the only academy that runs outside of school time. So our Martial Arts Academy runs 2 mornings a week, starting at 7:30 in the morning until 8:30 in the morning. The days that they are decided are upon when we meet our athletes for the first time, we discuss it with them, and then we determine the dates of which work best for the mass. It's either going to be run on Monday and Wednesday, or it's going to be run on Tuesday and Thursday. The partnership that we hold for this academy is with Bowman's Martial Arts, and he is the primary instructor with our other instructor, Mr. Craig Hillier. Again, this academy is the only academy that would not replace that of electives. It is also the only academy that could be paired with another academy. And so what I mean by that is if your child is an athlete that would like to try volleyball academy for the first time, but also would like to practice using their mixed martial arts, then they could participate in those two academies. That brings me to a question that is commonly asked with regards to academy is how many can students take at one given time? Like I said, you could only participate in one academy, and we do ask that student athletes that participate in the academy do so for the entire duration of what is suggested on this screen right now. If you want more information about athletic academies, you can always reach out to the school and speak to any of the vice principals or our principal, Mrs. Lisa Miller, or also you could reach out to our business manager, Ms. Geraldine Peterson, and she can further explain how our academies run. Just as a final reminder, on May 3rd, the same way that you would have received this link to join our Zoom, we will be sharing our Athletic Academy video that breaks down these academies a little bit more specifically with a registration form so that you can choose to register. If you have any questions before then, feel free to reach out to myself, Mrs. McConnell, Mrs. Van Lingen, Mrs. Miller, or again, Mrs. Peterson. Thank you all for your attention tonight, and we look forward to meeting some of our new trackers. And I'm going to pass it back to Ms. McConnell.
Hello again. So this week we had some very insightful and mature questions from our grade 6 students asking about some of the rules and what school looks like here at Father Mercredi. So a little bit of an overview. To keep Father Mercredi students in grade 7 safe, we do ask that they are closed campus. So we have a structure for that, but we do not let our students go out in grade 7 to the restaurants that are around in our area. They stay here at the school. We have a couple of dedicated vending machines for our students. In previous years, we did have a cafeteria space. This year, we do not. So we will see what that looks like when we get closer to school opening. Our students do need to sign in and sign out. This year, this was especially crucial for tracing, but it's also crucial for us to know who is here, who's signed out, who is not. We want to be sure that we're mindful and keeping you in the loop. To ensure we're promoting a positive and healthy environment, students are not to have energy drinks on campus. Also, students are not to use vapes or any other tobacco or smoking products here at the school. A common asked question is that around cell phone usage, and I know that we shared a bit about that in the video. Students are permitted to use their cell phones in our facility, but it's the responsibility of the student to manage it under the teacher's direction. Students are permitted to wear hats, but we kindly ask that they are mindful of the expectation in our morning routine that they remove their hats when Ms. Miller does our land acknowledgement and our opening prayer for the day. Another common question that is commonly asked surrounds students who are looking to switch homerooms. As Mr. Power just shared, homerooms are determined based on many factors, and one factor most certainly is academies. That being said, we are open and as accommodating as we can be to homeroom requests. The earlier we receive those, the more we are able to often accommodate such requests. We also do gather information from our elementary schools about who is best to be together in grade 7. We want everyone to make new friends, but we also want our students to feel that they are safe and respected here. And so we want to make sure we have happy homerooms. Lastly, we certainly understand uncertainty and anxiety, but we are here for you and we are here for the students. So we did share that they're welcome to reach out to us and send us any questions that they also may still have. Mrs. Van Langen is going to share some fun stuff about getting involved in being a trapper here at the school. So one of our big suggestions when you are choosing which school best fits your needs, one of the biggest recommendations that we would give is that you find somewhere where you can get involved. So whether that's with athletics or leadership and student initiatives or with its different clubs, it's really, really important that you find somewhere that you are going to participate and become part of that school community. So in regards to athletics for middle school, in the fall, we typically start with football, cross country, and volleyball. Then in the winter, we move to basketball. And in the spring, we have badminton, soccer, and track and field. One of the really nice things for middle school is that we do try to have multiple teams at the middle school level, so that as many students who want to participate in those athletic programs, especially volleyball and basketball, have an opportunity to do so. Our leadership and student initiatives, one of the biggest ones that we do at our school is obviously the Santa's Anonymous campaign. This lasts in the fall and the winter, and we have students from all grades that participate in different leadership activities in order to make the campaign successful for the community. We do other different charity challenges similar to what they do at elementary school. So we may have a food drive, et cetera. So those do still happen, and we look forward to having students who take on a leadership role to help promote those activities. And in the higher grades, we typically do mission trips every other year where they go abroad to help out internationally. Some of our school clubs include our Safe Zone, our Robotics, Games Club. We've had a lot of questions from students about, well, what happens if you don't see a club on there that you want to join and you want to create your own club? What we recommend is that you go see your vice principal so that you get some support in order to make your club happen and that it's effective. So again, one of the biggest things, just make sure that you get involved in that school community and find somewhere where you can use your talents.
Now, thank you again for being here tonight. And like we've all said, it was lovely meeting your children throughout the week this week. Hopefully you've had the opportunity to chat with them and just discuss where you think that you would be best served and which school would do that for you, because we do want you to make a good conscious decision about that as well. We did send some registration packages out to the elementary schools, or you can register online, which is available for you. And we've sent that link out as well. If you have any questions, you can see that you can write to FM at fmcsd.ab.ca. We will answer those questions within 24 hours. Or if you have questions right now that you do, that you have them ready, you can, of course, chat and we will answer them this evening. I do want to take the opportunity to thank the administrative team for being here tonight. It's always a pleasure actually to spend time with these three individuals. They're just so good at what they do and so dedicated to the education of your children. It's always such a great opportunity. Thank everyone involved with the making of the video and to everyone that joined us here tonight. I believe there's a question about, and Mr. Power is going to come forward and answer it now. Mm-hmm. So once again, thank you. Can't wait to meet you all. Take care.
Okay, so there's two questions that we just saw that were sent in to Mrs. Van Langen. The first question is, when do we sign up? So again, registration right for the next school year is already open. So you can go to the fmcsd.ab.ca or Fort McMurray Catholic School Division website, and you will see the link that says register, and you would just select what school it is you would like to register your child in. And the other thing that Mrs. Miller already suggested is, I know there's registration packets that have been provided to the elementary schools, so I think you could also retrieve them there. And the second question is if Mrs. McConnell is going to speak to with regards to one of our clubs.
Hello, we received a question about what our English language classes are like in the sense of English as a second language. So we do literacy intervention for all of our grade 7 students. We do an assessment at the beginning of the year to determine what sorts of interventions we can put in place for all students. So for our students who may be reading grade levels ahead, we push them to do more. And for our students who might need a little bit of other intervention, we work with our classroom support teacher to develop programming. So for some students, that will look like separate intervention where the students work in groups. For some students, it might be some one-on-one support with an educational assistant. It would really look however it needs to look for that individual student. If you have very specific questions about your child as an English as a second language learner, then we would really implore you to reach out to us and we will connect you up with our classroom support teacher who can give you more information.
So I feel like this is a revolving circle here, but so we have another question that came in. It's a really great question, actually. It's especially during these times, is what happens if my child needs counseling support? On site, there are two counselors that work here at Father Mercredi. And all you would have to do is, again, reach out to the school. You could speak to the grade level vice principal. You could speak to the classroom support teacher, or call student services directly at Father Mercredi and request to speak to a counselor. And that could be set up as soon as possible, as soon as your child arrives in grade 7. There is another way you could do it, as we do speak to some of the other, or we speak to all of the other elementary schools in Fort McMurray Catholic Schools. So if you just share with your classroom support teacher that you would like that service started when your child arrives at Father Mercredi, they can also connect us with that information. Another question that came up was regarding academies and about starting points and skill levels. Again, our athletic academies are for all skill levels for all children. So if your child is new to a sport and just wanting to explore that sport, they are able to take it. We have multiple staff that attend our academies with our children, and therefore we can start to program plan based upon the levels that get set up, that are demonstrated when they come to the academy. So academies are open to all students, all skill level, and we will work with them as they arrive at Father Mercredi.
He's right. It's kind of a revolving door. I'm just up here to reply to the question that asked about French immersion. Unfortunately, we don't house the French immersion program here at Father Mercredi, but they do have a very strong and wonderful French immersion program at our sister school, Holy Trinity. So if you are moving from a French immersion school and you want to continue on that program, we're sorry we don't offer that. But of course, once again, our sister school, fantastic, does have that available for you. Thank you.
Okay, so that seems to be all the questions that are in the chat right now. And again, if you do have any questions that pop up, or as your children are hearing and seeing the different videos that are going to be put out there in the community, if you have any other questions, just reach out through that email at fm@fmcsd.ab.ca, or simply give our school a call and a grade level administrator will get, or our principal will get back to you as soon as possible to answer that question. Thank you very much for being in attendance with us. We appreciate that you guys are joining us virtually. We know that people are zooming out almost, but we just appreciate that you took this time with us and never ever hesitate to reach out to us at Father Mercredi, as we want to be here for your children as they transition from grade 6 to grade 7. Thank you all very much.